Hello Data Vaulters, welcome to our series of presentations providing an orientation to Data Vault 2. This is a 7-part series and this video is part 5 where we explore the data model. If you remember from our previous video, we're interested in a travel business. You want to build a data pipeline for a single source table, bookings, from the booking system. We're going to break the table down into hubs, links, and satellites. Why? Well, because the source table contains an assembly of data about all kinds of entities. If we can break it into parts, we can assemble views of data about the entities of interest for the business. It's probably better to see this in action. What is held in a booking table? Usually there's information about customers, and the brand the booking is for, the product that was sold, details of the holiday and payments, and the timing of the holiday. The only reason they are together is they are provided when bookings are made. There's no reason why we need to hold brand information with seasons or holiday dates. Here's a mocked-up booking table. In reality, booking tables can have hundreds of columns. This booking table has some customer information, some address information, a phone number, information about the brand selling the holiday, product and product group information, booking details, status and dates, flight information, accommodation details, resort information, transactional information about the booking, and information about the season. So one physical booking table contains information about 12 separate entities of interest. These entities are candidates for hubs, and we should really be breaking this data out into separate records. Let's look at two of the entities, customer and booking. We create a hub for each and only put the natural key into the hub record. These are across the top of the diagram. We also create a satellite for each of those to contain the rest of the data. Satellites are shown across the bottom here. Hubs have satellites. They're linked to satellites. Our satellites are point in time. They hold information about when the payload details were set. So we add effective from and effective to dates to each of the satellite records to record when we knew the data held those values. If payload values change, we create a new satellite record, we end date the previous record, and set the new record to be effective from the date the data is available. It's very important to choose natural keys for your hubs. We have selected system keys for our customer and booking hubs. These may not be the best choice. Booking, for example, may be better identified by the date time of the booking, or the brand plus date time created. Why? Well, source systems can change during the life of a warehouse. Each will have a separate identifying system, identifying reference number. Numbering schemes can change, and we don't want different schemes overlapping. We know that customers make bookings. This is a link. Links can only connect to hubs. They form a many-to-many link. So here we show that a customer hub may have a link to a booking, many bookings. So a customer may place many bookings, and a booking may be placed by many customers. This may be true over time if customers change for a booking. Links have effectivity. So a customer booking may cease, or a new customer may take ownership of a booking. So we create an eFactivity satellite, and this holds effective from and to dates for the link and no other payload. All of our tables can add metadata. We want to know when records were loaded and the source system providing that data. So we add load date and source fields to each of the tables. DataVault 2 uses a technique to calculate primary keys. It runs an MD5 hash of the natural key, or concatenated key if more than one column makes up the key. You could use other hashing algorithms as well, such as SHA. MD5 produces a 128-bit hash value, and this can be stored in a char32 column. There's a tiny chance of a collision. That's where the MD5 algorithm generates the same key from different source text, but we've never seen one. Remember, we're not hashing for security purposes, we just want to have a manageable single column key. It also means we can populate the hub, link and satellite tables with key values in parallel without the need for foreign keys or incrementing fields. It all leads to a more performant system. We also use hashing to detect if a change has happened in a satellite. Remember, satellites are point-in timetables. They hold payload information about a hub, and as we get fed daily updates from source systems, we need to work out if any satellite values have changed. In SQL, we'd have to write a check for each row in the table, with logic a bit like this. Remember, we'd have to check if fields were equal, if one was null and the other one was not null, or they're not both null. It works, but it isn't easy to read or update and generates a very long SQL statement. Instead, why not concatenate all the payload fields into one string and take the MD5 of that string? Then hash the string and just compare the hashes to see if the payload has changed. We call that a hash diff. Here we've added the primary key hashes to each table. Satellites also have hash diffs added. And satellites inherit their parent hub or link's primary key hash and use load date as an additional column to create a compound key. So in summary, the booking table is quite rich, and proportionately though, not many source tables are rich. Most of them are quite simple and map to one or two hubs at most. That richness translates into multiple entities of interest, and those become hubs, and details become satellites of hubs. If hubs are linked, we add links, and links can also have satellites. We add metadata, and we hash the natural keys, and finally we use hash diffs to detect if payloads change to drive our point-in-time logic. If you need to get hold of more detailed information, you can download user group presentations from the user group website. We also offer DV2 and information governance-related blogs and white papers from our company site. These are all worth checking out. Thanks for viewing this video. See you in the next.